All right, among the reasons we like Dave Asprey is because he invented this bulletproof coffee, which got a lot of attention. He is going to show us, by virtue of glasses, that we can sleep far better.
Yes.
And he has an unusual theory about sex and sexual activity. We'll get to all of it. It's nice to have you here. New book we'll talk about in a second. This bulletproof coffee, were you just fiddling around with different recipes, or what happened?
I went to Tibet to learn meditation from the masters, and I was at 18,000 feet, and a little Tibetan woman gave me yak butter tea, and I drank it, and my brain worked in a way that made no sense. I came back to Silicon Valley, and I started hacking, and about 1,000 tests later, the right coffee beans, grass-fed butter, not normal butter, and something called brain octane oil. You blend it together. It tastes really good, but your brain turns on, and you have no sugar cravings.
Huh. All right, and you have how many cups a day?
I have one or two cups of that a day. Mm-hmm. And I've lost 100 pounds and kept it off for more than 10 years.
Whoa, really?
Yeah. As a result of the coffee, frankly.
The coffee helps a lot.
All right. Yeah. I tell you what, this prompted you, A, you could buy that coffee at Whole Foods and elsewhere.
We'll be rushing out for that.
Yeah. We've done about 175 million cups of coffee. It's sort of taken the world by storm.
And this book, Game Changers, essentially how to bulletproof your life to a degree. Yeah. And I tell you what, one thing that struck me, which seems counterintuitive, you say, in terms of sexual behavior and sexual activity, if you're a man, less is more, and if you're a woman, more is more.
In terms of orgasms, yes. In terms of sex, it's more is better for everybody. And what I did is I interviewed 500 people I interviewed on Bulletproof Radio, on my podcast, and I asked all these people who've done really big things, what are the things that matter most for you? And then teased out the common patterns. I don't want to follow one guru, but if 50 people agree on it, maybe that's worth our time, right? Mm-hmm. And it turns out that, according to Taoism, that when a man has a full orgasm, that it takes away some energy and there's a recovery period. And I tested this and actually published the data for a year's worth of trials. And there's an equation for that. And so it's when you have fewer orgasms as a man, you'll probably want to have a lot more sex, which raises your oxytocin, is good for you. And for women, it turns out they don't have that effect. So more orgasms generally raises oxytocin. So it improves relationships when you're a little bit careful about, you know, how far you go.
See, it's very, because I think a lot of people think that successful sex involves an appropriate conclusion for men and for women.
It's hard to talk about this, isn't it?
No.
It's kind of creepy hearing it from Sam, but okay.
No, it's been for ages, the athletes, male athletes, right. Boxers, yeah. They say stay away from the wife and the girlfriend.
So there's some proof to that, huh?
And Napoleon Hill, like the original guy who wrote Think and Grow Rich, a book that's changed millions of people's lives, he has a whole chapter on that, but it's something we never talk about because, well, it's hard to talk about. But I'm like, all right, I'm just going to lay it all out there and explain what's going on and why it's different for men and women and talk to the experts about neurohormones and all this. And there's great science here and people try it. They're like, oh, I got a raise. I have so much more energy. I started a company. This stuff happens all the time when people just control their energy.
Among the things that you explore in Game Changer about controlling and direction of energy, were there things that surprised you? Where, you know, you walk into something thinking, oh, well, maybe it'll be this way. And then,
you know, you talk to 500 people like this, Nobel Prize winners, Navy SEALs and all that. And I asked them all the same question. Three most important pieces of advice for people who want to perform better at everything they do as human beings. So it's not just about work or athletics or whatever. Not one person ever said fame, money, or power was a big goal. None of them were pursuing that. What came out of all this research was just three things. They are things to be smarter, faster, and happier. So they became wealthy or successful or made a big difference in their part of the world because they learned how to be happy, and then that brought about all this stuff. The people who are like, I have to be rich, I have to be famous, they generally are struggling and suffering, and they don't like their life even if they achieve their goals.
Mm. Now, I'm struck by smarter I get, happier I get. Why faster?
Well, if you want to become a certain kind of person or you want to do some big goal, you want to change something in the world, you're only here for so long. And if you just waste a lot of time, you don't get to do it. So they're intentional about where they invest their time and energy, and that makes them faster.
We talk about a lot of different things here. When Dave walked in with his glasses, and we have these big studio lights that you can't see, but you see the brightness on your screen. Why are your glasses important, and you have other glasses that can be helpful?
Yeah, these are called True Dark glasses, and these are blocking half the blue light. And this is also in Game Changers. And the idea here is prioritizing sleep for people who want to just feel good and live longer, perform better, it's one of the biggest things you can do. And it's not very expensive to make yourself sleep better. So for me, blocking all this really bright indoor light during the day helps me sleep better at night. And TrueDark makes another set of glasses that help you sleep even better that you wear before bed. So the idea here is by changing the color of light going into your body, you mean you can get more sleep in less time? I'll sign me up. That's part of Faster right there in Game Changers.
Wow. That is really striking. As you have hacked your life,
yeah.
Have you dramatically improved your life?
I've improved my life in so many ways. As a father and a husband, and the ability to write, you know, New York Times best-selling books and be CEO of a venture-backed company and run a big podcast and still like my life and be able to sleep and mm-hmm. Play ping pong with my kids, I couldn't have done that in my 20s because I dropped a lot of the stuff that was stressing me. And that's a big thing that all the people I interviewed, they figured out how to own that. And so I just didn't know who to follow. I said, well, what if I just average 500 winners? Maybe I could learn something there. Right. Man, they
One thing you talk about, and this is my word, is to remove the toxicities from your life.
Yeah.
The people who bug you.
Yeah.
Et cetera.
I mean, it can be people or it can be the French fries.
Right.
It could be completely either one. But the things that are causing that inflammation, whether it's just the friction at work or whatever, you just get rid of that. And then the first rule in Game Changers isn't, you know, eat something special. It's learn the power of no. And just say no to things you really don't want to do that suck your energy. And just that alone, it changes your whole life.
There it is. More information about all this, it's bulletproof.com. Really nice to meet you this morning.
Sam,
thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dave.
Thank you.